Unfortunate. I mean, he had 2.5 and you'd wager that should be enough, but apparently not. Here comes Kyatt with a shotgun on the doorway. As a grenade comes singing round. Shepherd catch him on the flip side. It's a trade coming through between the two, but that will be the elbow cleared out. That's what you're looking for mainly. You'll take the one for one in that position as Virtue goes for yet another Yonker. Again, a direct trade back. It's back and forth between the two until Always gets one without response. Hungry finds that response. A one versus one, but whereas Always, he hasn't got the fuser. He's going to have to try and push for a kill. Knows roughly where the man is, but can't find him. First round going the way of G2.
They brought him down to about 30 HP at this point, but Kayak is holding strong. They still need to get him out, and there comes the nade. As we say it, we speak it into existence. Down with the nade kill onto Kayak. We'll clear out that top floor, but the thing is, the top floor is not really the focus. We're thinking here about the downstairs. Virtue still holding inside a pig, and do they know? Oh, what a flick onto Shepherd's head that was. Still two left, and let's not forget again that we're focusing on the downstairs site here, Ace. This is going to be a Hail Mary. The drop coming in. Hungry, he's got a shotgun at the ready. One drops in. It's as simple as that. Citizen finds one, and this is why that clock is so important to watch, Ace.
A good while to get inside of the map, and there, as of yet, hasn't been any pressure coming into sight. Once again, I've commented on that already for Empire, ooh, but they managed to find a bit of vertical pressure there. Virtue goes down just after Yonker. Hungry starts to fight back, but it's 4 versus 2, and pressure's going to mount inside of sight now. Joystick at the top of White Stairs gets himself a kill onto Citizen. 1v4 now. Hungry's got it all to do.
Oh, man, it's, yeah, really difficult at this point where every time G2 steps somewhere, there's a drone catching their movements and Empire responding. Kind, Dan the man from above, brings down the final one. Hungry, falling to the ground, as so does the round for G2.
Big question.
This is it. It's all down to timing now, does it? It's all how long dare he hold on before he makes that push down rear stage, but it could be absolutely critical when it does come in. It could be lethal Yonker to the Empire efforts. Yonker's going to find himself downed. It sounded like an explosive, so potentially an air going in. There it is. Virtue goes big from the mid tower and finds himself a triple. We saw it early in the round and we were just waiting, Des. We were waiting for them to be ensnared in his trap, and that's exactly what has happened.
Well, the question I asked or said, patience is a virtue, but is virtue patience? The answer is no. Citizen coming out with another. He's completely put the lights out of Empire. Citizen and Kayak stepping up to be the closing kills for the team.
The solution to the problem that is Virtue. Not only that, but Citizen's playing underneath in meeting, trying to get aggressive onto that hatch angle if they do push up into attics or something that Team Empire again need to be aware of. Yonker just holding down security for the time being. Challenge from above will be shut down. Dan finds the kill. 4 versus 3. Here comes Virtue, shut down by Dan as well. A big round from him, but the time is ticking by. It's down to Citizen. 2 versus 2. Gets himself a triple. Hungry once again. Where have we seen that before, Des? And the answer is back in round number 3.
This move in Team Empire, don't leave it to that last 10 seconds. Scyther well aware of the potential for Citizen coming on the flank. Always shuts down Hungry, who was trying to move himself back to site. And that leaves only Yonker and Kayak in sight with a lot of work to do. Ooh. And they are not getting anywhere as Joystick moves in and gets the kill onto both of them. It's all up to Citizen. He gets the first, but he's got 4 more to find. Shepard's getting that diffuser down. That's the second for Citizen, but he's seriously low health right now. Diffuser activated and the round is done as that final kill comes in. Empire, they're going to manage to get one back for a 4-2 half on the attack. Seconds left to go, and G2, they need to get moving. They need to get something happening here. Kayak's dropped into sight with the diffuser, but he's going to go absolutely nowhere as Dan puts him down.
Hungry.
Hungry with a double though. Always manages to find Citizen. 3 versus 3, 15 seconds left to go. Diffuser down, cold. G2, they need to recover that or they need to start finding some kills quickly, and that's not going to help as they push in. And Dan finds one. 2v2, 2v1, a Shepherd on the shotgun always finishes things off. Empire lock down the laundry, and just like I thought, we are on for a game.
The first one coming out of Joystick, the second one out of Virtue. Unbelievable accuracy onto those instant headshots against some of the best gunners in the world. Now with white control though, Virtue starting to walk his way up. We've got 15 seconds to go, and Dan sprays through the smoke with the frost, finds one for himself. Scyther another, always a third, and like that, it has been completely shut out. We waited to see what the Capital could do. Apparently not a lot. Empire get the shutdown with 4 kills in a row.
That's a great use. How much utility has he
he's soaked at this point just by lying behind that obstacle.
Where'd that smoke go? I'm not quite sure where he threw it, but the evil eye now being consumed off the wall. We spoke about those, and look at that. Utility removed essentially for free here. Virtually pushing in behind the bump. Finds one onto Shepard. They've removed the man playing behind the bunker and now have control of the stage side. Hungry, though, down in the process as Citizen finds a second kill in the round onto Scyther here. 5 versus 3. Hungry back on his feet, but they've got to worry about the vertical kayak. Honestly, sublime timing. Perfect time to arrive and bring down Joystick, and now Yonker can go for the plant on the stage. In comes down from the side, shuts him down, the cover wasn't there, and gets the second onto Hungry. How has that happened? Kayak finding another from outside. A 1 versus 3 for Dan. Shouldn't be walking away with this one, Ace, but you never know.
Absolutely not, but he's already got himself a double. Misses his shots there. No. That's his moment, Dan. That's the opportunity to get this down into a manageable portion size, but no, he leaves himself with a 1 versus 3, and he's bitten off a lot to chew here. Diffuser goes down, lots of work to be done. Just tries the pot shot through the soft wall, not going to find anybody like that. I wouldn't expect the challenge comes into him in kitchen. Surely a matter of time here. There we go, Citizen it is to find that final kill. G2 get themselves ahead again
to Freezer particularly and start aggressing through the rotation that's been opened up. 25 seconds left to go. It's time to get moving, G2.
Down finding one, Joystick a second, the Citizen does start his push in, but they've already been slaughtered everywhere else. 3 kills fly the way of Empire, the fourth onto Citizen, completing it out. And Hungry, despite the work he was doing earlier on, has nothing really left to offer here. Got to try and push his way in, sees the one man at the top of the highway. We'll find him, doesn't know about the player and utility. Empire bring us all square once again. It's 5-5, Ace.
Just using them to move men around as well, force Scyther away. Scyther's currently watching the security door, I believe, from above, so that's going to prevent the push. What a nade comes in from Kayak and just closes down both Scyther and Dan. That's a massive play for G2, Dez. If they can crack the nut of this site, this is a huge move for them inside of this game. It will give them the advantage and the opportunity to close it out and head into top spot. Virtue shuts down Joystick, 5 versus 2 now, and there is very little that Shepard
always hold on. Always has had a fantastic season, maybe not so much a game. And Shepard now, with the smoke coming out, is going to block this window. We've got 40 seconds to play, and Virtue's at the window. Does Shepard know? I think he does, but can't do much about it. In come the team, jumping in. Yonker almost being sprayed down, but he's being absolutely crushed. The impact's coming out. A Citizen always finds one, makes it a second. Can he connect the third? No, he cannot. Doesn't know where he's being pushed from here at any given moment's notice. There is one on white. It is Citizen. G2 up now to 6-5 at the end of round 11. One more, and they beat the Russians.
But keeping himself alive in this fight, 45 seconds left to go, and he's just holding them at bay.
No,
he sees Citizen, he gets a great kill through the vertical angle. You got to remember they work both ways. Virtue, he manages to find that nade kill, but Dez, it feels like it's too little, too late.
Too little, very too late as well. 2 minutes 15 is consumed inside of there, and now G2 get into trophy. They're only just starting to deal with the shield that's in there. In fact, it's not even cleared, Ace. They've got the laser gates in place, the mute jammers, the wall is half opened up, but that is by Empire's design. They've got to move so fast here. 10 seconds on the clock in a 4 versus 3, else we go through to overtime. Kayak stepping his way up, Virtue playing downstairs below, maybe not where you want to be right now. Shepard with the shotgun finds one. That should be about it. Kayak going to find himself the next man going down. If he steps around the corner, it's a total closeout by Empire. All the way back from Always playing in Armory, we get overtime.
Behind Pillar, but I think he was looking towards Highway, and that one even clip the edge of the pillar. Maybe something you would come back to rue here is it could have been a nice easy kill coming in. However, when the frags are out, it's frags with a gun coming in. Always the one that falls down to Virtue, pushing down onto Big Tower. And now Scyther's aware of his presence. He's got to be a bit more mindful. You never know what he might be able to do on a bit of a mad sprint down. But as G2 have found several times this game, they're running out of time. 10 seconds to go. One came for the drop through. It's 2 kills coming in for Empire. They're going to move themselves up to match point as that diffuser is on the ground, unable to do anything. They're going to close it out. Empire win round 13, one round away from bringing down G2.
As the seconds just tick away, as the sand runs through the hourglass, and Empire still haven't got themselves established on the site yet. 3 versus 5, 20 seconds left to go. We've seen the chip damage coming in. Will it take its toll on Empire? Virtue holds an angle. He's prone. He just steps himself up, looks to take the challenge. No, Scyther with a team kill, 3 versus 2, but the pieces start falling, and they all fall in the favour of Team Empire, who take an overtime win against G2 and push themselves to the top of the EUL table.